Some people like to splash and play. Can you imagine that? Leave this video a big thumbs up if you are obsessed with Mary Poppins Returns, because I cannot stop singing the song, Can You Imagine That? And all the rest of the songs. Hey guys, welcome to today's video. You guys could probably already tell I got a little bit of a different lighting situation going on. Got front light, got back light, and it's getting professional here on the channel. Except for that's not professional. You guys already saw the title of this video, and this is going to be a story time of the eBay buyer and seller from literal hell. It's also going to be a little bit of a get ready with me. Nothing too fancy. The main meat of this video is the story, so I'm also gonna be doing my makeup as I tell the story. And if I remember, I'll show you guys what products I'm using. If I don't, sorry. I use the same products in like every video, so just watch any other makeup video and I guarantee you it will be the same products. Let's start at the very, very, very beginning. So if we go back to spring of 2018, I was upstate visiting my sister at school and my phone just went kerplunk. I had the iPhone 7 and it completely died. And for some reason, I wasn't able to do a hard restart. Up in Oneonta, there's no Wi-Fi, you're in the middle of nowhere. And so I went to the Verizon store with my dad and the guy literally said, you have two options. We could either fix the phone for you or your contract is up this year. We could just start you up on a new plan and you could just keep the same number, obviously, and put a down payment on a new phone. So that's what we decided to do because our contract was gonna be up in November and it made sense. I ended up getting the iPhone X, which is the phone that I have now. I absolutely love it. When I got home finally, I was able to turn the iPhone 7 back on. And so my other option, because it wasn't able to turn on when I was at the Verizon store. So the guy said, we can't trade it in, but if you do get it to turn back on or you come here and you get it fixed, because that was gonna be like a couple hundred dollars if they were to fix it. So he said, the best option is try to fix it yourself and then sell it on eBay. So that's what I was gonna do. That's what I did actually. So fast forward, it is now November and I wasn't able to sell the phone prior to November because they said that we still had money owed on the phone and you can't transfer users or accounts until it's paid off. And so November came, the phone was paid off, but I had still not posted it on eBay yet. Like I wasn't ready for that commitment yet. But then December came and I got an email from eBay saying that if you listed a smartphone by December 1st and you sold the smartphone by December 31st, you got a $40 eBay gift certificate. So I said, that's great, that's bomb.com. I can sell my phone, get a little bit of extra cash, and also come away with a $40 eBay gift card to get something else, you know, treat yourself. And so I listed my phone, not realizing that the listing was gonna end on Christmas Eve. But that being said, I said to myself, you know, everyone knows the holidays are here. Things are a little bit different, a little bit slower. The United States Postal Service is a little bit slower around the holiday time. And so I felt that anyone who bid on the phone would be understanding of that. And boy, was I wrong. Basically, the eBay buyer won the auction on Christmas Eve. And then what's the next day, everyone? Christmas Day. Now, whether you celebrate the holidays or not, Christmas Day is when the post office is closed. And so I had to wait until the next day, which was the 26th. At night to drop off the package. So I knew at this point that the package wasn't gonna get scanned in on time, but I had no other choice because I had family commitments and I was communicating that with the buyer and they kept saying, my package, where is my package? My package, my package. And I kept explaining to them that A, they're lying about the shipment that they purchased because they purchased 3 to 5 days and that's what I sent it on. They claimed that they did 1 to 2 days or 2 to 3 days or whatever, and that was a complete and total lie. So January 1st or 2nd comes around. It was like the first weekend in January. I get a notification on eBay that the buyer is filing a claim against me saying that I'm taking too long to ship and asking for a full refund. I posted the tracking. Like they could tell that the item was on the way. It's not as if I hadn't shipped it yet. and eBay was trying to put it on me that the item wasn't scanned in on the 26th. It was scanned in a couple days later, and then it was processed and sent to the buyer or whatever. But that's out of my hands. And so I explained that to eBay, and then finally they were like, okay, we're gonna close the case in your favor and no refund is gonna be issued to the buyer. That happened, and then the next day comes and I get another notification from the buyer saying that they received the item finally and they want a full refund again, even though I listed it as no returns, saying that the item was damaged when they received it. So here's a picture of the item when I sent it. And here's a picture of the item that the buyer claims the item looked like when they received it. Now, you could probably tell by these pictures that the item, the phone that we are talking about, the picture of the phone was taken in direct sunlight, so there was like dust particles all over it. But eBay had the audacity to tell me that the only thing that they could do for me was have the buyer send the item back to me, and if the item is damaged when I received it, to file a claim with eBay. So I get on the phone with eBay now. I had called them over and over again, and I said, listen, I don't have time for this. I sent the item in good faith. I knew the buyer was gonna do this because they were upset that the item came a little bit later than expected, but it was expected because I explained to them that it's a holiday week, you know, anywhere from the week before Christmas to the week after Christmas, it's very hectic. You know, there's a lot of packages being sent out. It's not all about you. And I was very nice to the buyer though. Like, I wasn't mean or nasty or anything. And so eBay finally closed the case in my favor. You know, they said after hours on the phone with them, they said, listen, we're going to close the case in your favor. You know, the buyer is just trying to cause a little bit of trouble. They're just annoyed that they didn't receive the item on time, but we've deemed that the item was in fact how it was described. So I wrote on the listing originally that it was no noticeable wear or tears. And the buyer said that there's a deep scratch on the front of it, which wasn't true. It was dust. Like, take a cloth and wipe it off. Like, you're good. eBay really wanted me to go through this whole process in like accepting the item back. And I said, I'm not going to do that because the buyer is probably going to damage the item and then it's going to be worth nothing when it comes back to me. And I don't have time to keep filing all these claims. Just close the case in my favor. Let's call it a day. So they did that. And sure enough, the eBay buyer left me a really negative review. Insert picture here. And so, unfortunately, sellers cannot leave negative buyer reviews, but I did leave this negative positive review as pictured here. I was just kind of like, okay, that's over with, that's done with. Boy, was I wrong. So a couple days later, I get an email with this $40 eBay gift certificate that I got for selling the phone. And I said, okay, I'm gonna buy myself one of those portable karaoke mics. If you guys follow me on Snapchat, link down below, I got one of those portable Bluetooth karaoke microphones that I jam out to, and I was really excited to purchase this microphone. So I purchased it from one seller, and basically about an hour after I purchased it, the seller reached out to me and said, listen, we forgot to update the listing, but we no longer have that item in stock. So I was like, that's a bummer. So I just let it go. I was like, whatever. So I repurchased the item from a different seller. And then a couple days goes by and the tracking hasn't updated. So I'm like, wow, that's really sketchy. So now I contact the seller and I say, listen, I purchased this microphone from you. Can you tell me when it should arrive? Like, what's the deal? And he says, and I quote, confession time. And right away I'm like, this is going to be a sob story of why he can't just send me my item. And this is a different seller, by the way. This is not the buyer from hell. This is a seller from hell, a totally different person. So basically the seller says to me something along the lines of him and his daughter do eBay full time. And if that's your full time job, whatever, like, it really has nothing to do with me, but you claim that you're this professional eBay seller, if that's even a thing, yet he wrote the wrong address on the box and it was sent to somebody else, or something about the daughter brought it back home and he never changed the label. But the two options that he was giving me was to refund me my money or to send me a different item, which I thought was really sketchy because he just said that he packaged my item and sent it to the post office with his daughter and that his daughter brought the item back because it had a different address on it. So I was like, why can't you just put my correct address on the package that you were gonna send me originally? So that didn't make sense to me. So I was like, you know what, just cancel the order. Like, that's a little bit suspicious. Like, I'm not gonna risk that. So at this point now, there's been two sellers who don't have the microphone that I wanted. So of course, when it came time to leaving reviews, I left both the sellers neutral reviews because nothing bad happened, but nothing good happened either. You know, they both coincidentally messed up on this one item and I was like, there's something up. And my thing is with eBay, the reviews are meant so that other buyers and sellers know if they should look out for anything with a specific shop, especially a buyer to a seller. And I felt that leaving a neutral response was a good response. Not for this seller. So the first seller, I didn't hear anything from. They accepted the neutral response. I think they left a comment like, sorry, we couldn't help you or whatever. Now, the second seller, though, completely flipped out on me. I couldn't believe that this person was taking this so seriously, because my thing was, is that, you know, I get it if selling things on eBay is your life. This guy was trying to make it seem like selling on eBay was like his livelihood, and if that's really your main source of income, I get that. Like, I fully get it 110%, but the way I feel about reviews is that I'm not going to leave a dishonest review, because if someone else goes to buy something from your store, like, I want them to know what to look out for. You know, it's money. And the thing with the coupon was that I had to call eBay now and have them reissue my coupon twice. And on the second time, they weren't going to reissue it for me because they were like, that's kind of sketchy that you keep using it and then the order keeps getting canceled. And I said, well, if you take a look, it's not me canceling the order. There's two different sellers and they keep canceling my order. I ended up getting a few Studio Ghibli movies. I'm not pronouncing that correctly, but one was The Secret World of Arrietty. The other one was Castle in the Sky. And then another one was My Neighbor Totoro. Hope I'm pronouncing that right. But I ended up getting those Blu-rays instead with the $40 gift certificate. So I was like, I'm not going to risk buying the microphone a third time and having the seller cancel the order. So I ended up getting the microphone from Amazon, but that's besides the point. This seller is flipping out at me and they were just giving me a hard time about leaving this review. Finally, to the point where I had to block them. I blocked the seller and the buyer both, even though they had nothing to do with each other. And I was like, in the matter of a month, what are the odds that I dealt with two really obnoxious eBay seller and buyer? Like, what the heck? Moral of the story is, be respectful of everyone and the fact that even though you're not celebrating, others might be. And I was being very nice to this person, the buyer. I was communicating even with the seller who was getting mad about my review. He asked me to explain why I gave him a neutral review, and my thing was, is that I left the neutral review because, again, I wanted to let other buyers know what to look out for, because it seemed like a scam to me, to be honest with you. And could it have not been? Very much so. But to me, it seemed like a scam and I just didn't want to risk it. You know, it's not really, it didn't seem like such a big deal to me. You know, I didn't leave them a negative review, but according to him, negative and neutral comments reviews are the same and it's going to cause him to lose revenue. And all of a sudden, he didn't have a daughter anymore. That was the other thing. It was like, very sketchy that you keep telling these stories when all I want is my microphone. So that's pretty much it. I don't know if I said it in the beginning of this video. I can't remember because I had to restart this video like 1,000 times because it is so hard to film any videos in my house. I said I was gonna do a get ready with me. Don't know if I said that. Also didn't really do anything. I think the last take I put some bronzer on. That's pretty much it. I think I'm going to end this video by showing you guys this infamous microphone that I keep talking about. This is my microphone, the one that this whole thing revolved around. It took so long to get this, but now that I have it, it's like my favorite thing in the entire universe, and I don't know where my life's been without it. This is not sponsored, but it does also play music. I'll show you guys. Stop watching. My neck is popping. You like my hair? Gee, thanks. Just got it. I want it. I got it. Yeah. Isn't this like the best thing in the entire universe? Well, I'm gonna go now because that was the longest story time ever. I think this is like 20 minutes of me trying to get this together. I tried to tell the story already like 4 times. That is why I'm all over the place. I hope after I edit this, it'll all come together in a cohesive way because this story is in parts and I have to edit it together and I'm just all over the place. I don't know if I said that I was supposed to do a get ready with me. I didn't do that. Lots happening right now, so I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.